Hi guys, assalamualaikum. Welcome to my channel. Nama saya Amiza. I know a lot of you guys will start bullet journaling next year, and you guys have been asking me a lot about this notebook. So hari ini I akan review this notebook, which I don't know what it is called. I think it's book notebook, or I call it the owl notebook. Before we start this review, I would like to clear that this notebook is not sponsored. I bought it using my own money, and all the review in this video is my honest opinion. So these past few months, I tried cari dotted notebook dekat Shopee. Shopee is no strange to those who love to shop online and on constant search for cheaper solution. I came across this cute owl notebook. The price is around 60 to 70 ringgit if I'm not mistaken. I sebenarnya tertarik dengan cover dia sebab it comes with 4 different pastel colors. It has 160 GSM paper. In case anyone doesn't know, GSM ialah berat paper. So secara hipotesisnya, makin tinggi GSM, makin tebal paper. And I figured, untuk paper yang tebal dengan price range yang macam tu, dia sebenarnya considered quite cheap kalau kita nak compare dia dengan standard notebooks yang jual dekat overseas. So after I placed order, I waited around 2 weeks for this notebook to arrive. My first impression was the cover feels so smooth. I think it's pure leather cover. The paper feels thick. It comes with one bookmark, a pocket at the back, and a stencil as a free gift. I list down some more features of this notebook so you guys can get a clear picture. I am comparing this notebook with the standard A5 size of my scribbles that matter. This is my current bullet journal, and as you guys can probably tell, the size is similar. Tebal dia lebih kurang sama, tapi STM has 200 pages, which is lebih 40 pages compared to this notebook. The dots are not too visible, and I sangat suka sebab the paper is very very white. It also opens flat just like any other standard bullet journal notebooks and is not numbered. And of course, I bought pen test untuk tengok quality paper of this notebook. For this pen test, I tried to use quite a number of pen sebab I nak tengok how the paper fare. So I start off the pen test with the Staedtler 3 Plus Fine Liner, the Artline Supreme Fine Line, Staedtler Pigment Liner 1.0, the Crayola Super Tips Pentel Foot Touch Pen, Zebra Mild Liner Brush Pen, Sakura Koi Brush Pen, Artline Sticks Brush Marker, Zig Kuretake Brushables, Tombow Dual Brush Pen, Artline Supreme Brush Marker, Stabilo Highlighter, and Sharpie Marker. So from the pen test, I can conclude that the paper is somehow coated sebab it feels very smooth masa tulis, it absorbs ink, so I give them credit on that. One tips for you guys, kalau korang nak cari notebook untuk bullet journal, kita tend untuk tengok berat paper sebab macam I cakap tadi, lagi tinggi GSM, lagi better sebab kita sometimes guna journal untuk lukis, untuk colour and use all the brush pens and coloured pens that we have. So paper thickness sangat penting, but please also check if the paper is coated or not coated. This one, kalau you tak sure, you can ask the seller sebab I pernah jumpa paper yang 100 GSM suppose is thicker compared to 80 GSM yang macam standard notebook but is not coated. Paper jenis macam ni tend to absorb ink and will definitely bleed through. Coated paper will give you nice vibrant colors. Susah untuk bleed, but dia akan ambil masa untuk kering and tend to smudge. So back to this pen test. I don't know if you guys can see from the video, but there is actually mild ghosting dekat certain pens and kind of see-through from the Sharpie. I've definitely seen a result yang lagi better from well-known brands. So kalau korang tengok review I pasal Suki Bullet Journal, yes, hands down, that one's definitely one of the best. But this Owl Notebook doesn't really disappoint me juga. So untuk paper quality, I give it a strong 3.5 out of 5. The binding is average. I wouldn't say the worst, but it's definitely not the best. So do I recommend this one for you guys? Yes, I do. It works well dengan watercolor juga. Tapi I terlupa untuk guna watercolor masa buat pen test ni. Korang boleh tengok video I yang lain. I pernah try guna watercolor on the paper and dia cuma wrinkle after I apply banyak air, but no bleed through. So untuk korang yang akan start bullet journaling this coming new year and korang plan untuk guna a lot of supplies, I do recommend this one for you. Tapi kalau korang plan on doing something very minimal and simple, I would suggest you to opt for cheaper notebooks with less GSM untuk biasakan diri dengan bullet journal system. So, I rasa itu je untuk kali ni. Kalau korang nak beli buku ni, I will definitely put the link to that Shopee account dalam description. So, before we end this video, please consider to give this video a thumbs up if you like it and help me to grow my baby channel by subscribing. And also, let me know if you have any questions and let me know what future videos you guys want me to create. I hope I can talk to you guys again in the next video. Until then, Assalamualaikum. Bye-bye.